Hello everyone, this is John, W5CYF. In today's video, I'm going to review and assemble the touch keyer made by CW Touch Keyer. They're out of Norton, Maine, and this is the model P3. This is the lower end model. CW Touch Keyer makes several different models, ranging all the way from the very basic that I'll be assembling in this video, all the way up to a very sophisticated yet simple to use and simple to operate touch key that has the keyer and some other adjustments included in it. The key that I'll be assembling, as I said, is one of the basic ones. In fact, I think this is the lowest end or the most basic that you can have. However, it does operate by touch alone. As you know, most CW keys are operate under the principle of two electrical contacts coming together, and that's what makes the dit and the dos. The touch key is different in that it works simply by finger touch. No pressure is required, just the touch of your finger, and it has a sensitivity to recognize that touch and therefore convert that into an electrical pulse that keys the keyer. The unit that I bought sells for $22, and I believe that did include shipping. The shipping was very quick. It got here within 3 business days, so I'm very pleased with that. So the next step is to take a look at the contents of the P3 and follow along the assembly sequence. Once the box is open, the kit, as you can see, comes inside the cellophane sleeve. Now, it does have some static sensitive parts in it, and we'll take a look at just exactly what those static sensitive parts are and open up the instructions and see what's involved. Once you open the package, you can see that there is the instructions that come with the unit. The instructions are simply 2 pages. They look like that they're very well detailed, and the steps are along the way. As I say, I'll give a review of exactly how the instructions are as I build and assemble it. The schematic looks like it's relatively straightforward, and it does have a printout of the PC board with it. The pink envelope to the right, here are the parts, and this is the anti-static bag that they're in. So we'll open up the parts.
Well, I just opened up the kit contents, and as you can see, it's a very basic kit as far as the components. There are 4 transistors, there's 1 diode, 2 capacitors, 3 resistors, and 2 ICs that are already mounted on the board. Now, they don't look like they're soldered yet. I'll go ahead and solder those in. They may be. I just haven't looked closely at it. I'll have to get the light on and get my optimizer on to take a look at it. So this looks like a very easy project to build. And we'll go ahead and start the assembly. I'm not going to go ahead and go through each step of the assembly. I'll come back when it's all put together and all the leads and so forth are soldered in there. So this looks like it's probably less than a 30-minute job. I'll try to watch the clock and give you a more accurate time before the assembly is complete. Well, that was a very straightforward and easy project. Total time involved, start to finish, was probably less than 20 minutes, and that actually involved me going and eating a small bowl of ice cream. There were very few components here. Now, there was one thing that I neglected when I was going over the contents list. I said there were 4 transistors. Well, when I poured it out, I had not read the entire sheet. Actually, there's 3 transistors, and there's 1 capacitor that looked almost like a transistor when I poured it out. But that's what the board looks like. It went together very, very well. The only thing that I found that I did have to deviate slightly with, the instructions, although they listed the resistors as 100K and a 10K, it did not differentiate the band nomenclature. For example, the 10K was a brown, black, orange, and the 100K was a brown, black, yellow. I had to go actually reference that. But other than that, very straightforward instructions, and extremely easy to solder, lots of room on the board and so forth. The board measures approximately, I would say, about 1.25 by 1.5 inches. You can see in relationship to the pliers next to it that it's a very small PC board. Now the only thing is lacking is to hook everything up. Now there were no external connections that came with this. I have enough of those in my spare parts to go ahead and attach those tonight.